just came through a neighborhood into another little section. I think it's kind of short, but I can never remember. Hi, buddy. Hello. Mistakes if you come on it by yourself and never been here before. So we're approaching the section that comes on, goes down Queen Street to the waterfront area. Okay, take a little tour on the hub trail post rain. And I'm just crossing Queen Street here into Bellevue Park. I'm going to take a little ride through here. This is one of the places that you can add on to your hub trail route if you want a little extra. Can't say as I know it all that well, but let's see what we can do here.
Good morning, folks. It's a wet day in Sault Ste. Marie, so I'm taking you on a tour of the Hub Trail, which is a 25-kilometer scenic loop throughout the city. I'll just be showing you the bits and pieces, but the whole thing is a worthy adventure. Unfortunately, I didn't notice the battery dying before I hit Finn Hill, as it is a super fast, fun downhill. In the woods along that section, they are also building a world-class flow trail that I would have liked to show you as well. If you ride the loop in the clockwise direction, you will enjoy the rewards of Finn Hill. If you love climbing, take it counterclockwise. I'm currently in Bellevue Park, which is a welcome addition to the ride, and if you stick around, you will see Whitefish Island, which is another good addition. And if you add these two to your ride, it'll be closer to 35 kilometers. I hope you enjoy the tour. Cheers from Busy Living. Thank you.
really think the last time I was on this, it was all like crushed gravel. That was quite fun. Seems to be all asphalt now. We're still on Queen Street here. We're gonna make a left up here. It's kind of goofy because it doesn't really tell you, so you gotta kind of know. Thank you. This can be kind of a slow area because, well, it's pretty popular, so. If you're looking to bomb it, you want to come early in the morning. Got in me. this is a pretty cool portion. It's the St. Mary's River. Sometimes you get to see big ships cruising through here. Should be able to see the bridge to the States straight ahead. the St. Mary's Rapids over there. They look like they'd be fun to bomb down in your kayak. Well, I've never seen anyone do it. Stack in the distance over the bridge there. Seen a cormorant catch a pretty good size eel one day. It was a pretty cool sight. I think this is the way to get to. Here's our lock. I gotta get across here. Cool, huh? the trails. Thank you. another. These are the signs you're going to be looking for anyways. Be bear aware. This is Fort Creek Conservation Area. It's another one of the highlight zones. A small little climb to enter here. It's really lucky. But it's a pretty beautiful little spot. Some sandhill cranes down in that little pond area before. Doesn't look like there's any there today. All right. This one, another one of those areas you can add more to your ride if you want. There's different, like, double track and single track trails in here. I've done a little exploring, but can't say I've done a lot, so I don't know it that well. We'll do it someday, but it's hard to spend too much time in there when you can go to Hiawatha and ride some great trails there. And they got some new ones I haven't ridden yet. Hoping to go there tomorrow, trying to give the system a little more time to dry out. Been raining pretty much ever since we got here. So doing the honorable thing. But there's also some fun little rock side events here that I would love to test my skills on. But not today. I already got a broken spoke that I'm riding on right now. Bridge number 2. It's another one of those should be a guaranteed wildlife sighting areas, but same as before, nothing. You gotta come early in the morning to hang out with a lawn chair. So that is the total paved portion through Ford Creek. Pretty little area. We're in the hospital campus right now. Sweet. Hopefully we go in there tomorrow. If you ride there on the road, you'll get to enjoy a deadly climb on the way there. But on the way back, it's a super smoking downhill. But then you'll have a long gradual climb up this road. Some of those more well-trained dogs I love. That's a rant for another day. On the right here is the Great Lakes Outfitters. It used to be the old Belarusian bike shop, which has moved closer to the Hiawatha trails, which is probably a good spot for them. Well, we're going to exercise the Idaho flow rule here. I believe that's the state that you don't have to obey stop signs, you know, as long as you're not being an idiot. If I'm wrong on that state, I know there definitely is one. I don't know if stoplights are on the list. There's a water tower in. But stoplights are on my list. I remember a cab driver in Florida saying, you can waste one third of your life waiting for stoplights as he proceeded to drive through a red. Get us to our destination quicker than we should have. So I'm approaching the end of the hub trail loop from where I started from my in-laws' place. Now this is going to dump me out on the road. Northern Ave, I think it's called. So hopefully you enjoyed what you've seen. I just tried to show you the main highlights. is nice. There's other things to see. This video is probably already too long, but I didn't want to make it any longer. So if you're like me and you just like to ride your bike and you're not, you know, a trail snob that needs something specific, try it out if you're in the area. You'll enjoy it. All right. Cheers and happy riding.